what protected me, a very dangerous situation. Some people know I have a state ministry. Weekdays, Monday through Friday, after coming from work, 6 to 7 o'clock, I show this big intersection, showing this board, one side, busy intersection. I'm getting a lot of encouragement by honking, also discouraged by bad words. Monday through Friday is my regular day. Weekend I don't do because less traffic. Last Friday, one of my friend, he's a Pentecostal, he called me, Rajangu, he wanted to, his mom came from India, his mom is Catholic. When she came before 2-3 years ago, they came to our home, we shared gospel. Now he said he wanted his mom to bring my home and share gospel, and Molamandi wanted to share the gospel. He came at 2:30, we shared the gospel. Thank God, she accepted Jesus Christ as personal savior, one thing, but good thing. After that, by the 5 o'clock, I cannot come here, that's why I didn't come last Sunday. As soon as finished, I went back to the state ministry as usual, Monday through Friday. Usually, I don't go Sunday because there's no traffic. Actually, I am doing this both sides, north side, and this side. This signal is on. I'll show this one here, and this is off. I'll go this side. That's why I show you. Whenever this signal on, I'll go there. So, one time, I don't know, usually I go this side in this country. One time, I didn't know when this signal is off, I supposed to go there. Within a split of a second, a big sound. One car came over the curb and run over the curb and went back to the street. Just the old lady. I was, just before I was there. I don't know why I did not go there. God, that was I, MIS, that's a very wonderful miracle for me. God protected me. God has a purpose on me. So that day evening, the family prayer meeting, I discussed with our family members. What happened? What is the situation? Something happened to me. So please pray for me. This ministry, what I am showing every day, Monday, very encouraged me. So our duty is spread the gospel to the whole nation. We are fulfill our Lord's work. That's your duty. Thank you for the time. Thank you. Pray for us. Thank you.
Yeah, thank God for all the big and small. You don't take anything granted. It is God's protection of his life and keep him alive and to be with us tonight. And we pray for him for the ministry also. Father, we come before you and we thank you, Lord, for you called each one of us. And especially, we thank you, Lord, for the passion and the hunger. And we thank you for the enthusiasm and excitement for our dear brother to spread the gospel to the people of God. And we thank you for the divine opportunities that you give to him, O Father. God, we pray that you continue to be with him. And we thank you from the depth of our heart, O Lord, to protecting him and keeping him alive and keeping safe from that danger that would have happened to him, O Father. Lord, we commit to him and your mighty hands, and we pray that you bless the ministry. And each time that he shares the gospel and lift your word, Lord, we pray that may your name will be glorified and people be attracted to you, O Father. We pray that you bless them as a family, and we pray for that mother who accepted you as a Lord and Savior. We pray that you continue to work in their hearts, O Father God. We thank you, Lord, what you are doing in their lives, O Father. We bless them, and we pray that you continue to be with them and guide them and use them, O Father. In your name, amen.